Hello students, today we are going to start new chapter in mathematics, that is ratio and proportion. Here the chapter is divided into two halves. That first one is the ratio and other one is proportion. So in today's lecture I'll give you all the concept that we are going to use in ratio, and then we go for a question related with the ratio. So let's start the topic. Let's start the topic with concepts. So the first concept is, though here in this lecture we'll do the concept related with the ratio only. The first concept is, if A and B are the quantities of same kind and in the same unit, then A is to B is called the ratio between A and B. Here the two important thing that we need to focus, same kind and same unit. Suppose if A is to B is the ratio of 3 kg is to 2 gram. So we can consider it as a ratio, but because they are of same kind. Same kind meaning it is the thing that we have measured for mass, and this is also that we have measured for mass. So these two quantities are of same kind and the same unit, but they don't have same unit. So if we need to find the ratio, then we have to convert them into same unit. Meaning if I multiply it by 1000, okay, because we know that 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram, so we get what, 1000 gram is to 2 gram, or we can say 3000 is to gram is to 2 gram, 3000 is to 2. That is the ratio. If I say 3 is to 2 is the ratio for that quantity, that would be incorrect. And if I write A is to B is 3 meter is to 9 kg. So that thing can't be expressed in form of ratio, because the reason is these two things are of different kind. One is with the unit of length and other is the unit of meter. So for ratio, the two things are important. One is of same kind and other is of same unit. Same kind is necessary. So if it is not in same unit, then we can use our system of conversion to make the unit same. So if I say it is 20 hours is to 3 minute. Yes, that can be expressed as ratio, because both have the unit of time. So we can convert hour into minute and then we can easily find the ratio, or otherwise we have to convert minute into hour. Okay, so anyone we can do the things, but we have to make thing in same unit. So always remember, if you just ever asked to find the ratio, then it should be of same kind and same unit. So then only the things can be expressed as ratio. Okay, the second thing, if it is asked, here this the term, if A is to B is this, now then this term is your called first term and this is called your second term. These two are called the term in the ratio. Sometime it is asked that convert into ratio. So just check, if they are not of same kind, you will tell they can't be converted into ratio. But if they are of same kind, then in this way you have to convert. Definitely in due course of time we will do the question related with the same topic. So the second concept is that, I hope that the first concept is clear to you. Now the second concept says, if both the term of the ratio are multiplied and divided by non-zero number, the ratio remains unchanged. Meaning, if if ratio is A is to B, and if I multiply this ratio like 2 by 2, then the ratio becomes unchanged. Or if I divide the ratio with the same non-zero number, the ratio remains unchanged. So that is the small thing, that is not much important concept, because you know that if I just cut 2 by 2, then definitely it will be a by b only. So that is the thing. The third important thing that is also not much important, but sometime you may lose your marks if you just forget this thing, this concept, that we express the ratio in the lowest term only. Always remember, if you express the here I found that A is to B, after calculating it is 3000 is to 2, but the way to express the ratio is not the correct, because always we express the ratio in the lowest term. So can you cancel out this thing? Yes, we can cancel. So if we cancel, we get the ratio 1500 is to 1. That is the simple thing. If it is 3 is to 8, so that can be a ratio, because we can't express, we can't further convert into the lower. So that is the lowest term, because okay. And the third is, if it is, suppose 16 is to 24, okay, 16 is to 24 can be expressed as the lowest term, that is what, 2 is to 3, if we cut it with the table of 2. So whenever the question asked in form of ratio, or so you just have to express the answer in lowest term only. So that is the concept, and that is the property of the ratio. Next comes comparison of ratio. Comparison of ratio is nothing but what you have done in your previous classes. That is what is that comparison of ratio. Suppose you have two ratio, A by B and C by D. If you have to compare these ratio, so just multiply AD. If the product of AD is greater than product of BC, okay, then in that case, your A by B is greater than C by D. And opposite, if your BC AD is less than BC, then your C by D is greater than. Means you can say this, otherwise vice versa is true. And if AD equal to BC, then A by B becomes equal to C by D. Okay. So next is composition of ratio. In composition of ratio, you have to learn a few new things that may you have not done in your previous classes. So first is compound ratio. So what is compound ratio? So when we multiply two ratios, suppose the one ratio I have 2 is to 3, and other ratio I have 3 is to 5, or if suppose I have 4 is to 5, I have the two ratios. So what is the compound ratio? Compound ratio is the ratio that we get after multiplying the two ratio. First ratio is my 2 is to 3, and the second ratio is 4 is to 5. Then what is the compound ratio? It is 8 by 15. So 8 is to 15 is the compound ratio for the two. So if we have three ratios, 1 is to 3, 2 is to 4, and 3 is to 1. Suppose we have three ratios, we need to find the compound ratio for that. So just multiplication of all the three. 1 by 3 into 2 by 4 into 3 by 1. So whatever you get here, you can, if something is cancelling out, so you can cancel out these things. So whatever you get, it is 6 upon 12. So 6 is to 12 or 1 is to 2 is the compound ratio of this. So in to find the compound ratio, you have to multiply the two given ratio only. Okay. So the next is duplicate ratio. If you have understood this compound ratio, then you can understand the duplicate ratio very easily. So if you have two equal ratio, suppose A is to B. So what is duplicate ratio? The compound ratio of two equal ratio. If A and B into A and B, that is what called duplicate ratio. So that is what A square upon B square. If I ask to I have a ratio 2 is to 3, find the duplicate ratio of this. So the duplicate ratio for this is 4 is to 9. 2 is to 3, 2 by 3 into 2 by 3, the compound ratio of two equal ratios. Okay, so that is what called duplicate ratio. Similarly, triplicate, the name itself says three times, triplicate. So it is the compound ratio of three equal ratio. So if I ask 2 is to 3, so compound ratio of three equal ratios means I have to in order to find the triplicate ratio, I have to multiply thrice. Okay, so what I get? 8 by 27. So 8 is to 27 is the triplicate ratio of 2 is to 3, and 4 is to 9 is the duplicate ratio. Duplicate means you have to do the square. Triplicate means you have to do the cube. Sub-duplicate ratio. Sub-duplicate ratio, the square root of given ratio. So if the ratio is 4 is to 9, suppose, then its sub-duplicate ratio is the square root of the given ratio. So if you have like ratio, if you have a ratio 25 is to 16, and I asked you to find the sub-duplicate ratio, so that would be what? The root of this is to root of this. So that is what? 5 is to 4, that is the sub-duplicate ratio. Similarly, sub-triplicate ratio, you have to find the cube root. If I ask, if I have a ratio 27 is to 8, find the sub-triplicate ratio, then sub-triplicate ratio is the cube root of this. Cube root of this, that you will get 3 is to 2. Cube root of 27 is this 3, and cube root of 8 is 2. So that is what? Sub-triplicate ratio. The last is reciprocal ratio. So you have, if A is to B, the reciprocal ratio will be your B is to A. If it is 2 is to 3, the reciprocal ratio will be 3 is to 2. So let's start with some questions. So we have, you have a question. A is to B is 5 is to 2. You have to find the value. To solve this type of question, you have two methods. I am just showing you both the methods. So you can use any of the method to solve these questions. So the first method is K method. Okay, the first method is K method. So here I just substitute A by B is 5 is to 3, that is given. Okay, so that you can consider, let A is equal to 5k and B is equal to 3k. So if you substituted this, now you have to find the ratio of 5a minus 3b upon 5a plus 3b. So 5 into 5k minus 3 into 3k upon 5 into 5k plus 3 into 3k, that is 25k minus 9k. Okay, upon 25k plus 9k, that is 16k upon 34k. So k and k is cancel out, but there's the property of ratio says the ratio should be expressed in lowest term. So 16 is to 34, that you can express as 8 is to 17. So 8 is to 17 is your answer. You can use this method, that is the very easy method, but I'll show you the other method also to do this question. So the second method is, you have the value of a is to b, that is 5 is to 3, right? A is to b, that is 5 is to 3. You have to find this. So you can divide the numerator and denominator by b, okay? So if you divide the numerator and denominator by b, what you get? Here, what are you doing? Just you can write here over the sentence that divide numerator and denominator by b. Now the value of a by b is 5 is to 3. So you can substitute is 5 is to 3. Okay, 5 is to 3. Now this will be 25 by 3 minus 3 upon 25 by 3 plus 3. So after solving, what you get? Okay, so this will be 16 is to 34, that is 8 is to 17 only. But while solving these fraction, you may do some mistake. So that's why I just must say to you that you should use this method. Otherwise, you can use any of the method to solve this type of question. So let's take some other question. In this question, we have given the ratio a minus b upon a plus b is given 1 is to 11. Here the ratio a is to b is not given. So what first you have to do? First find the ratio a is to b. How can we find out? Well, just cross multiplying. So if you cross multiply these two, you will get what? 11a minus 11b is equal to a plus b. So 11a minus a will be b plus 11b. So it is 10a equal to 12b. So a by b will be 12 by 10. So you can write a is to b will be 6 is to 5. Now you got the value of a is to b. Now you can use k method. Let a is equal to 6k and b is equal to 5k. If you know the value of a and b, what you have to find? We have to find the ratio 5a plus 4b plus 15 upon 5a minus 4b plus 3. So 5 into 6k plus 4 into 5k plus 15 upon 5, just I am substituting the value of a and b, what I got from here, okay, minus 4, b is how much? 5k plus 3, so it is 30k plus 20k plus 15 upon, this will be 30k minus 20k plus 3, so it will be how much? 50k plus 15. This is 10k plus 3. If you take 5 out, you will get 10k plus 3. Okay. And in the denominator, it is only what? 10k plus 3. So this and this will cancel out. What you got at the end? 5 by 1. So your answer will be 5 is to 1. So another question that is similar type of that. If that is the question, m plus n upon m plus 3 n equal to 2 by 3, though we have to find the ratio to n square upon 3 m square plus mn. So if you know what I am going to do, I just first cross multiply this and then I find the value of m is to n, and then I use k method to solve this question. So if you know the concept, then if you understand it properly, then just pause the video and do by yourself, and then at the end just check the answer. Okay, so now if you cross multiply, then what you get? 3m plus 3n equal to 2m plus 6n. So after arranging the like terms together, you will get what? M equal to m equal to 3n, or m by n will be 3 by 1. M is to n will be 3 is to n. So let m equal to 3k and n is equal to 1k. Now what you have to find? The ratio 2n square upon 3m square plus mn. So it is 2n square. In lieu of n square, you can write 1k square, 3k square, because the m is 3k plus mn. Plus mn means plus 3k into 1k. Okay. Now if you just calculate, you will get 2k square. Here 9 into 3, 27k square plus 3k square. So it is 2k square upon 30k square. K square will cancel out. So your answer will be 1 is to 15. So let's see one more question. So you have now in this question that is opposite, just opposite of the previous type of question that we have done. Here we have to find the value of x is to y. What is given? X square plus 6y square equal to 5xy. If you divide the whole equation by y square, then what will you get? Why I am going to divide it by y square? Because if I divide it by y square, I will get something by x square by y square. That's why. So divide by y square. If you divide by y square, you will get okay, so x by y whole square plus 6 equal to 5 x by y. Let x by y as m, because whatever the value of m you got, that will be the value of your ratio of your x by. So you can replace this at like that. If you substitute x by y as m, now it is minus m plus 6 equal to 0. Now just factorize it by middle term splitting. So m square, it is minus 2m minus 3m plus 6 equal to 0. If you substitute by middle term splitting, okay. So if you have any problem, any doubt in the middle term splitting method, so you can go for my videos that I have made the separate videos on that factorization. So m minus 2 minus 3 m minus 2. Okay, so now your solution will be m minus 2 m minus 3 equal to 0. So m is equal to 2, m is equal to 3. So x by y will be equal to 2 by 1, or your x by y will be equal to 3 by 1. That is your answer. Let's see one more question. Divide rupees 1290 into A, B, C such that A is 2 by 5 of B and B is 2C. So this question, here it is given A by B is 2 by 5. Okay. A is 2 by 5 of B, I can write. So I can write A is to B as 2 is to 5. And B is to C as 4 is to C. For doing this type of question, I need to find A is to B is to C. So how can I find A is to B is to C if A is to B and B is to C is given? I have to make these two equal. So A by B equal to 2 by 5. If I want to make these two, means denominator of the first ratio and the numerator of the second ratio, I have to make these two. If I just multiply this ratio by 4 by 4, then I get 8 by 20. This is very important thing. Just learn it properly. And B is 4 by 3. So I just have to multiply this with 5 by 5. What I did, I just multiply this by this ratio by this term and this ratio by this term. Okay, so this will be 20 by 15. Now I can write A is to B is to C as 8 is to 20, because this 20 common and 15. So 8 is to 20 is to 15. Okay. So now that becomes question very easy. So A's share will be how much? 8 upon 8 plus 20 plus 15 into total 1290. So 8 upon this is how much? 43 into 1290. So if you cancel this, so you will get 30 here. So you will get 240 A share. Similarly, you can find the B's share as well as C's share. So B's will be 20. So 20 upon total into 1290. These type of thing you are doing in the your previous classes also. So this is 30, so this will be 600. C share will be how much? 15 by 43 into 1290. That is how much? 450. Okay. So here the question is, what quantity must be subtracted from each term of the ratio 9 is to 17 to make it equal to 1 is to 3. So we have to subtract something from each term of the ratio 9 is to 17 so that it becomes equal to 1 is to 3. So let x must be subtracted. Okay, x must be subtracted. So if I subtract x to each term, then the ratio becomes 1 by 3. That is according to what the question says. Now just cross multiply and find out the value of x. That will be your solution. So if you cross multiply, so you will get how much? 27. I am just separating the like terms. Okay, so you will get 10. So x will be 5. So 5 must be subtracted. So here we have to find the duplicate ratio. So I just told you in the concept that duplicate ratio is the compound ratio of the equal ratios. So if it is A and this is B, so I just need to find the duplicate ratio. So duplicate ratio will be the square of this thing. Okay, duplicate ratio will be square. So square of this will be the duplicate ratio of this. So how do we do the square? That you have done in your class 9 in the chapter 3rd. How do we do square of this? The square of this will be 9 and square of this will be 3. This is 4 into 5. That will be 27 into 20. Okay, that is 27 is to 20 is the duplicate ratio of this. Here we have to find the triplicate ratio. Triplicate ratio means we have to do the compound ratio of the three equal ratio. So that is what cube of the ratios. Cube of the given ratio is what? Triplicate ratio. So cube of the given ratio. So that is n by 3 cube. That is how much? M cube by 8 is to n cube by 27 is the triplicate ratio. So here in this question I need to find subduplicate ratio. Subduplicate ratio meaning square root. So what I have to do? The square root of this. So subduplicate ratio. Okay, subduplicate ratio will be x minus y raised to power 4 to the power 1 by 2. Square root I can write this way also, because I know that square root of x meaning the power 1 upon 2. That's why. So I have, in lieu of root, I have written this. And x plus y raised to power 6. If I need to find the subduplicate ratio, I have to do square root. Now, if I simplify this, I can write like this. And if I simplify this, this will cancel out. So, that is the sub-duplicate ratio. So here we have to find the sub-triplicate ratio. Sub-triplicate ratio means cube root. Okay, cube root. So sub-triplicate cube root. Triplicate only cube. Okay, don't confuse with these things. So if I need to find cube root, I can write like this way, right? Because cube root, I can write the cube root of this can be written as power 1 by 3, right? So this will cancel out, and here this will become 5y. This type of thing you have done in last year in the chapter exponents. So that is clear, that should be clear to you, that 1 raised to power y raised whole to power 1 by 3. So that can be written as 5 raised to power 3, y raised to power 3. If they will cancel out, you will get this. So your required ratio will be this. So here in this question, x plus 3 raised to 4x plus 3 is a duplicate ratio of 3 raised to 5. So this is the duplicate ratio. Duplicate ratio means square. So this is given according to question. This is the duplicate ratio of this. If it is given, it was given sub-duplicate ratio, we have to do root of this. So now just solve. 4x plus 1 equal to 9 by 25. Just cross multiply. So if you separate, you will get what? So we have question, find the ratio compounded of the reciprocal ratio of this. So what we have to do, the reciprocal ratio of 15 is to 28. The second, sub-duplicate ratio of 36 is to 49. And third is triplicate ratio of 5 is to 4. We have to find these three things. So first, if we find the first we have to find these three things, and then we have to find the compound ratio of all the three. So what is the reciprocal ratio of this? This will be 28 is to 15. Sub-duplicate ratio of this will be how much? Root, na? Okay, so that will be 6 is to 7. Okay, and triplicate ratio meaning the cube, not cube root. Sub-triplicate ratio is cube root. So it is 125 is to 64. Now you got the three required ratios. Okay, now you have to find the compound ratio of all three. So how do we find the compound ratio? Just multiply all the three ratio. The result that you get is the compound ratio. Now how can we simplify this? Okay, cut, reducing the lowest form, so that will you get the compound ratio. So we have done the question and the concept related with the topic ratio. So go for a practice on the same topic. In the next episode, we'll teach you the concepts of proportion and the question related with the same.